I'm Shamila Shaban. I'm one of the ladies that were hitting in Bechamod. My friend and I were walking on the streets of Bechamod, and suddenly this guy comes from behind us and hits me with a car. So after hitting us the first time, the second time, and even the third time, so it's when my friend was like, okay, do you know this guy? Why is he doing all this to us? Why does he want to hit us? My friend came to him and started asking him those questions. You're having your wife there and your kids at the back, and you're doing this to us. Is this the way you're teaching your children? So the guy, I think the words offended him. He came out of the car and he held my friend and he started hitting my friend. So I was really so scared. And I tried to run away, you know, because of the fight and the way he was hitting my friends. But as I was standing watching my friend being hidden, I was, you know, I cannot run away and leave my friend in this mess. So I came back and I tried to help my friends. The guy where he had parked his car is where the family business is. I think that the family saw all this. The brother came and held my friend by the hair. He also came and held me by the hair. And he told us to kneel down. After he was holding our hair like this, that is the time that he hit us too much. It attracted a lot of attention from people. A lot of people came, and nobody came to try to rescue us or to ask the guy, why are you hitting us? Everybody that will come, they will all get the opportunity to hit us. They hit us too much, and the ladies there, they were calling us names, you sharmutas, you are black people, you're in our country today, you're going to kill you. They really offended us too much. I really could not understand, you know. At some point, I tried to ask myself, what exactly have we done to these people that they are hitting us this too much? I even tried to look at the faces that were hitting us. I could not even recognize one face. You know, if you're having a beef with someone, or you did something wrong to someone and they're hitting you because of that, then it's another thing, but you don't even know anyone. So this guy comes and hits me with his knees here. So that is the time that I lost consciousness and I fell down. I don't know how long I was lying down there, but I woke up with a crowd of people on us. I looked on the left and I saw my friend. I was really so much heartbroken because the way my friend was hit, if you could look at her lips, I could not really recognize her face again. Because she was being hit on the face, on the lips, all her face was really, really so swollen. I looked up, then I tried to, you know, to see if there is any lady or someone who could try to rescue us, you know, or someone who could say, like, Haram, these are my fellow ladies, they're being hit by men, it's not good. But I did not see anyone. All I could see in their faces were hatred, and they were calling us names and calling us, okay, sharmutas. So this time it's when my friend told them that we are not sharmutas. My friend was telling them, I'm married and I have a child. So these words really offended them too much. They hit her really bad, and she took out her phone and tried to call the husband, to call the consulate for help. They hit her too much because they did not want her to call for help. They did not want us to say a word. They did not want us to move. There was even a knife, okay, next to us. They told us, if you try to escape, we're going to cut your heads off. I looked on their faces, but there was no one who had humanity in their eyes. They were all like bitter and angry. So they called the police, and before that, the brother to the guy came. So Hadar is from the army as well. He was wearing a khaki uniform, and he told us, I'm horny. You know, it's a way of intimidating us. So the police came and they took us to the Macfire in Bechamod. We got the statement of what exactly happened. And the police there, they told us that the guy you were involved in the fight with is from the army. And tomorrow morning, okay, you're going to be taken to the prison in the army. And your case is going to be handled by the army. So, okay, from there, we were really, really so scared. The next morning, a guy came. He told us that he's a doctor. He took photos of us. So I think he saw that how bad we were hurt, and the next thing I remember is that the guys came and told us that we need to sign some papers. So from there, we're really so scared, you know, we didn't even ask why we were signing the papers, we just signed the papers. After signing papers, we were told that the case has been finished, we don't have any case with the army anymore, and now the case that we're having is that we don't have papers, so they're gonna take us to Naba. And then we'll be taken to the immigration. Like, the case was finished, but there was no justice. Actually, we stayed in Naba for a week, and then we went to the immigration. And in the immigration, they saw how bad we were looking. Our faces were all scars and bruises, and no one even cared to get us like treatment. The lawyer came, and she told us she's from the United Nations. She heard about the fight, and she told us that she's going to stand with us and try to help us in court. I was told that she tried to come and see us, but at the immigration, they could not allow her to come in and see us. They took us to court. I had hopes that I'll be released, but I cannot be released when I did not hear anything from my kafil, and she did not even come to make a release for me. Later on, I was told that my kafil wanted to get paid. She wanted $3,000 to make a release for me. They told me that my ticket is ready. I told them I'm not gonna sign the ticket if I don't hear anything from my lawyer. They forced me to sign the papers as my ticket. I was taken to the airport. I told myself I cannot fight with these guys anymore. I think I've had it enough. And I even asked myself, even if I be released from jail and I go back to work, am I really safe in Lebanon anymore? Maybe they will come looking after me. I think I was done fighting.